Hello, Bar McCarthy here from Bold&Break. I am delighted to be back with a new tutorial. In this tutorial, we will be expanding on the video we did 3 weeks ago, which is where we combine the matrix, emitter, and tracer object to create growing spline-like particles. We're going to be texturing it in this video and looking at topology and a few tricks of how you have a little bit more control over your system. Here is what we will be creating. Before we get started, I have a channel announcement to make. It's a small one. I will probably do a video on this and expand on what I'm about to talk about. The YouTube channel has been monetized, so I want to say a big thank you to everyone who subscribed, watched, commented, engaged, reached out on multiple platforms to me. It's been great. I've enjoyed it. Bold&Break now has a store where you can purchase membership for a very low cost, or we can purchase one-to-one mentoring, which I'm happy to do over Zoom. And there are a couple of products here, and we have some, you know, swag, as you do. I will be expanding the amount of products in the store. There'll be shaders, Redshift shaders. There'll be probably working files at some point. I'm hoping to build out this library with the weeks, months ahead, years. Hopefully we can go that long. So if you're interested, please look at the description below and click the link to the Bold&Break store. You can also donate via the thanks button on videos now. So we have our system from 3 weeks ago, which is fantastic. If we press render on Redshift, you're like, why is this not working? He sent me all this way 3 weeks ago and I can't even see it in my render view. If you right click on your tracer and you go to render tags, you go to Redshift object, and you will then have this option to change the mode of the curve. And the curve mode is set to hair strands. You will see our curves are now rendering in Redshift, and you can change the thickness here. My recommendation is to go with cylinders. Another very cool thing, let's just play this out. Here, you can just change the fall off of this quite nicely. You can see here that this will fade away and you won't get these hard edges. And if you want to do the same here, but obviously keep the curve, is you can hold control on this graph. And then you can bring this up, twist that around, and then you can bring the next one down there. And you get that nice fall off from your curve, so you're not getting hard edges. Here we can see the interpolation. Fast will be a faster form of interpolating things, but it might look a bit more jagged here. These edges are quite jagged. We'll get into that in a moment. You can mesh subdivide, which is helpful. I would just leave it at fixed 3. Now to the fun bit, which is texturing. The first texture we're going to do is incandescent. The incandescent material is basically set up to be just a pure glowing material. It's self-emitting light. That's what it is. We want to texture our curves, our Redshift curves here, with a ramp node. Put this into illumination color, and we'll go down to a ramp here, and we load the preset rainbow, and then we take our incandescent material and put it on our tracer object. We can see that texture. Now let's just take off our ramp for a second, go how this incandescent material is working. So if we put that up to 10 in the intensity multiplier, so we have our incandescent material node selected, and we can decrease or increase the intensity of the glow here. Let's keep this at 1 for now. And then if we bring our ramp in into illumination and color up the intensity there. A lot of people forget that the Redshift post effects add a lot of flair and aesthetic to your final images. Bloom effect here, if you bring down the threshold by quite a lot, you'll get that like nice warm glow. Let's bring down the intensity of 5 maybe. So you're getting that nice effect. Now, an issue with this, and sometimes when you want that control in Redshift, is we have this ramp and it's starting at the start of the emission and ending at the end of the emission. But what if we want to have the individual strands and curves in this system textured? How would you do that? There is a node called Vertex attribute. And if we take that and we put that into general alt, you will see it will just change the whole coloration of this. But if we select our vertex attribute, go to presets, curves, curve ID color, we have now told Redshift to look at the vertex within this system, and can you please look at texturing each one individually through the alt input of this ramp. Very, very cool. If you want more control over this, you can select all the knots. So These are the little knots here on your ramp. Select the N1 and hold shift, and then you have them all selected. Right click on the knot, go down to interpolation of all knots and select step. And that might change things around a little bit, but now you're getting a lot more control because this ramp isn't blended into one another. You basically have free reign over weighting the amount of color. If we take the orange, pump it up there, take down our blue. You can see you're now kind of waiting. Delete this. So this is super, super cool in terms of, you know, how you can weight the colors within this. Let's bring our threshold down again. Let's get this glow going and bring that up to 10. It's looking quite cool there. And we can also add just a little bit more radiance from the splines themselves if we tick streak and we bring down the streak threshold. You can see here you're just getting a little bit of a streak through this. Our splines are looking a little jagged, and this can get quite confusing quite quickly with Redshift, because you think if you're going to put up the max subdivisions it's going to fix it, or you mess around with interpolation. Then you go into your tracer and you can see here the tracer object. You can also change the interpolation, intermediate points, and how the splines are generated. You're swapping in between these two, and I've been there myself. The main driver of making this system, like these splines and curves, much smoother is the actual driver that you have in your force field. So it can actually, you can actually do models like geometry in the force field. So you got to make sure that these objects that are driving the direction of your spline are smooth. So in intermediate points, you could change that to adaptive. It should be much, much smoother. And it is. It's looking quite slick, which is very cool to our system. And just be aware, these won't have the same effect on smoothing out these jagged edges that we saw as much as the driver of your system, because essentially what it's doing is it's taking the points, the vertices, the intermediate points, and it's animating along those points. So you can add more points, or, you know, it could be adaptive. Your spline will be smoother, your curves will be smooth. Okay, we are going to do the same with a standard material, because maybe you don't want just a glowing material. So let's delete this off our material, go to Redshift, standard. We're going to do the exact same setup, shift C, vertex attribute, we can put it in there. We're going to just do another ramp, our out color into our alt input, take our presets, select curve ID color, load another preset. We're just gonna go for one that is stepped in the interpolation now. And we're gonna apply that there. And we have the same system. And the cool thing about this is you can make this reflective, you can make this shiny. You can also make this emissive. So if we go down to base properties, emission color, and just make sure your ramp isn't piped into the base color. And it's not doing anything. So we've got to select our standard material. Gotta go down to the weight of our emission, and there you go. And so you're still getting, you still can get an emissive material, like a glowy material with the standard, but it's more optimal to do it with the incandescent if the material only needs to glow. If you need reflection on the material, or you need roughness, or you need an alpha channel, or you need other attributes and properties, put it through a standard material and make it glow. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you for watching. Thank you for everyone who has subscribed over the last 4 years. Remember, please like, subscribe, comment. And if you're interested, have a look at the shop. I will probably do a bigger video talking about where I want to take the channel. The ideal situation is I can take time off to do more of these tutorials and some more interesting videos on tidbits in the industry and how it works and how we operate. But obviously I have my freelance career, my studio that I'm trying to run. Supporting this channel will help me take the time to put more resources into this channel. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.